Buddha up there. It's so
yeah.
cool.
Yeah, we've got some great pieces throughout the space.
Yeah, I saw the stone Buddha downstairs. Yeah. Beautiful.
Yeah, so this is where Ruby Room started.
Okay.
We started up here.
Hello.
Our acupuncturist.
Hi.
Chinese.
How are you?
Hello. She's one of our intuitives, and she's a Reiki master as well. So
okay.
Lots of good stuff happening up here. So we started up here. This is all things inner beauty, inner wellness. So working at the energetic level as well as the physical level with acupuncture and colon hydrotherapy. And then with our healers, they're really working to facilitate change and help you move forward on your path, and really helping you to help yourself.
Okay.
So it's not about somebody else healing me, it's about them helping me to heal myself.
Right. Would you mind introducing yourself on camera?
Not at all. My name is Pamela Policastro, LAC, licensed acupuncturist in the state of Illinois.
Beautiful. Okay. So one of the questions, I got a couple questions via
okay.
Twitter about acupuncture.
Yeah.
So one of the questions that I was asked to ask you is, how often should one get acupuncture? So you just did a treatment on me
yes.
to relieve stress and
yes.
all of that. If
yes.
I needed to come back, when would you say, is it like a weekly thing like a manicure or a monthly thing like a massage or?
This is on an individual basis.
Okay.
Acupuncture is very personal for each person. So depending upon what I'm treating, I can have somebody come back once a week,
mm-hmm.
say for 6 treatments,
mm-hmm.
then I'll reassess.
Okay.
Where do we need to go from here?
Okay.
If we're doing herbs, maybe I'll only need to see you once a month after that.
Okay.
Because herbs are also going to work into what we're doing to support what we're doing with the treatments.
I see.
Somebody may come in for something that's very acute. It just happened. I want to see them twice a week.
Okay.
Twice a week for 2 weeks, and then maybe once a week for 2 weeks after that.
Okay.
Everything is very different. It's very individual.
So
yeah.
For me, what
for
would you say?
For you particularly, if we're just talking about a stress level, I say once a week for 4 weeks.
Okay.
I also like to prescribe herbs.
Okay.
At that point, after the 4th treatment, we'll sit down and reevaluate. Where are you? How are you feeling? Exact measurements would be taken according to your signs and symptoms. What's going on with that stress?
Gotcha.
So we'll see. Well, how much has she improved? How much further do we have to go? How much more treatment? And how close together or apart do we want to make that treatment?
Okay, cool. Another question that somebody on Twitter asked is, if you are trying to, let's say, conceive a child,
yes.
is it recommended to get acupuncture? What is your opinion on that?
I specialize
well.
in fertility for women and women's issues and conditions. So acupuncture helps hugely
uh-huh.
with conception. Barring any kind of physical issues going on. If
mm-hmm.
somebody has clogged tubes, let's say, then no, the acupuncture is not going to help unclog this tube and help you to conceive.
Right.
The only thing I could say as far as acupuncture couldn't help is if, okay, I have a clogged tube, genetically there's something going on with my uterus, or acupuncture helps greatly with those who believe they're infertile.
Mm.
I don't really believe in infertility.
Interesting.
I have to tell you that. I do believe that if somebody undergoes something of a physical nature and they are no longer able to conceive, I believe that.
Right.
But if somebody has an unknown cause of infertility, that I don't believe.
Huh.
I believe that somebody really has the ability, if they work through diet, exercise, acupuncture, we work through every phase of the month for the woman.
Right.
We build up her egg quality, we build up endometrial lining, we change, we help FSH numbers, we help to balance hormonal levels, so there's many, many things we can do.
Wow.
Yeah.
Huh.
With wanting to conceive. And I can't even go into detail because there are so many different diagnoses.
Right.
You know, everybody has a different thing going on, but we also work with PCOS, we work with endometriosis, all of these things.
Is there anything that acupuncture cannot, like, definitely you're like, I can't cure this with acupuncture.
Yes.
I can't, what?
If you break your foot and you come see me the next day.
Yes.
I cannot do anything about it.
Right.
But if you come to see me a week later.
Okay.
I can help you after you've been set in.
Wow.
You know, what we do with acupuncture basically is we're tapping into your body's own ability to heal itself.
Mm-hmm.
We're not, I have to say, we're not really doing all that much,
mm-hmm.
but we're really just having a conduit that's helping the body go, oh, that's the way I need to go.
I got you.
We're redirecting things, rebalancing things. I think as far as, let's say you sprained your leg or you hurt yourself or you broke your foot,
mm-hmm.
that got set, and it's whatever happens with that, and you come back in. What we would do is we would create a better circulation of blood and chi. This alone helps the healing process and the healing time.
Huh.
You know, as soon as something's broken or hurt or injured, you get stagnation of blood, you get stagnation of life energy.
Right.
So just moving it
makes a world of difference.
Makes a world of difference.
Huh. Very cool.
Yeah, it is.
Well, I'm so happy. Thank you so much for your time.
You're
I really
welcome.
Appreciate it. I've learned a lot today.
I'm glad you did. There's so much to learn.